I'm Chris Cristoforo. I was doing an MBA project on the part-time English course of UCY, and we were part of a team for 2 years. That is our team: Christis, Yorgos, Nestoras, and Stella. It was actually one of the more mature teams in the part-time MBA. So it was two engineers, two electrical and electronic engineers, one civil engineer, one educator, and one lawyer. So that was the caliber of our team. And we chose to do academic entrepreneurship in the University of Cyprus with Professor Cassinis. Professor Cassinis was teaching a strategy in the MBA. And since the MBA was all about entrepreneurship and all about us creating our own companies or running our companies or making our existing jobs more fulfilling, we sort of got into that. The objectives of the project was to provide a better understanding of the UCY's entrepreneurship ecosystem and the perception in the academic community that existed as in the period where we ran the project was sometime between May 2016 until September 2016. Identify the degree to which the university was geared towards developing entrepreneurship initiatives. Identify bottlenecks and constraints in the current way of operating within UCY. And providing recommendations on the actions that the university should take and explore better practices on how they can be integrated in the existing community. The structure of the project was to identify the essential ingredients of an entrepreneurial university. I also identified the startup ecosystem in Cyprus. I understand that in the past 2 or 3 days you have spent considerable time in discussing the Cyprus ecosystem. You had some presentations regarding Cyprus startups, entrepreneurship, etc.
Yeah, yeah. We've seen live actual companies. We've seen.
What did you see in the past days?
Engino,
ne?
Yeah.
Idea program. We had Cocoon Creations.
Good. Prodo.io, yes.
Lots
I know of some of those people. So you got the feeling that the startup ecosystem in a university is undoubtedly influenced by the external ecosystem in the country that it operates. Okay, so this is more important in a place like Cyprus, which is such a small place. The community is so connected and linked to each other, and it's also an island. And the other ingredients that we were looking into, the academic entrepreneurship in the UCY as it existed at that time. The research methodology was one very important part of our project, and we will talk about it later. And the findings and recommendations. Now, the essential ingredients of an entrepreneurial university. First of all, is attitude towards entrepreneurship. Someone you before was talking about orientation and yes. So it's attitude towards entrepreneurship. It needs to be inherent. It needs to exist within. It's an argument whether you're born with it or you're developing it. Now, address skill and deficiencies in the world systems, identify those within the academic environment. Education training for university members, cross-collaboration between individuals and faculties and external stakeholders of the UCY, and coordination of those activities. You probably went through that, okay, defining the startup ecosystem, so I won't go into detail.
No, we have not defined it this way, so.
Okay, so a startup ecosystem, it's very similar to these bubbles. So you've got all these bubbles around the ecosystem or in the ecosystem. So it's the support organizations, the big companies, the universities, the funding organizations, the service providers, and the research organizations. And all these all the links between these bubbles. It's the ideas, the inventions, and the research, the startups at various stages, the entrepreneurs themselves, the people, the team members, the investors, the mentors, the advisors, and all other people from related organizations. The incubation process, in its classical form, it's an important part of the entrepreneurship, both in academic environments, but definitely in industrial environments, in the commons. Did you have any incubators like?
We saw idea.
You saw idea. So yeah. Idea is both an incubator and an accelerator in that sense. So you get the idea of the incubation that happens in Cyprus. We should also say that UCY, Cyprus University, University of Cyprus, has an incubator called Diogenes. It's a bit dormant now due to some legal formality issues or discussions, and which are bound to be resolved in very soon. The startup financing cycle, so it's again a basic financing cycle in that sense. You've got the slow dip, that's the value of death, and then you're climbing up slowly, and then you're sky high. Okay, that's the wishful thinking scenario, of course. Now, the startup ecosystem in Cyprus and its support structures, was very important to identify for us when we started this project. So we identified these support structures, which is the Diogenes, was the original incubator in UCY, Helix, another incubator, Hermes, Chrysalis Leap is a very niche incubator, accelerator, and it's working with energy-related projects, and it has considerably, to the size of Cyprus, huge success in getting awards in European Union competitions. It has been getting Cyprus announced and discussed about in European Union regarding green energy projects and initiatives. Chrysalis Leap is somewhat associated also with the Cyprus Technological University. What do you call it in English? To the back. Okay, we've got the CITA Innovation Center, another initiative by the Cyprus Telecommunication Authority, and Cyban, which is the angel investors, the Cyprus angel investors. The mentors and coaches, only recently C4E announced a mentors list, which has gained traction within UCY. And there are a lot of startup events, startup live, startup weekend, open coffees, Hack Cyprus, space apps, and we also we have co-working spaces like Destin Co, Urban Hive, co-work space. Successful startups in Cyprus, you've probably seen Prodo.io and Engino, Polfish, Alcaro was a recent success in Cyprus with a recent acquisition, Teach and Go. So these are good examples of mostly tech-related startups in Cyprus. The business incubation mechanism in Cyprus, as discussed before, the Diogenes was one of the first incubators of University of Cyprus, Helix, Hermes, Chrysalis Leap, CITA Innovation Center, Cyban, JDEA. The role of University of Cyprus in the startup ecosystem was identified as the entity to contribute to the production and valorization of knowledge. Valorization is not just about getting value out of the knowledge produced in academic technology. Valorization goes beyond money. it's how you put that idea into practice and what it creates further. So it's valorization is a term used by a lot of academic entrepreneurship universities or universities that apply academic entrepreneurship principles in order to promote in a better way and in a more diffused language the concept of applying knowledge and creating value out of it. Engage in research and development, stimulate the complex processes of innovation and entrepreneurship, and support new ideas and foster entrepreneurship itself. The University of Cyprus internal ecosystem is quite substantial. It has a lot of different entities. It has the C4E, Center for Entrepreneurship, is the grounds that you are sitting today. And it's one entity within UCY that has been trying to promote entrepreneurship for the past at least 2 years. The Diogenes Incubator, the research centers themselves, the faculties and departments of the university are part of the ecosystem. The students, the academic staff, the researchers, the graduates, the alumni of the university is part of an ecosystem. The cooperation networks that exist, FOSS, GIOS, Oceanography Center, industrial partners outside the university that relate and cooperate with the university itself, and all the stakeholders essentially of the University of Cyprus can be considered as part of the ecosystem.
Excuse me, what do you mean by Cyprus Entrepreneurship Competition?
UCY established the Cyprus Entrepreneurship Competition, yes.
You have competition in entrepreneurship?
UCY organized it, yes.
It's a prize, organized.
Sorry?
It's a prize?
Award.
Prize, award?
It, yes, it had a recognition.
Hackathon?
Hackathons are different. Hackathons are usually organized by industry or private sector.
Okay.
So, there are a lot of, if we go previous to, like Startup Live, Startup Weekend, Open Coffee, Hack Cyprus, Space Apps, those are events or competitions that are used to stimulate and bring together young startup entrepreneurs and also individual, mostly techies. You see why? Try to develop entrepreneurship through the support of the Cyprus Entrepreneurship Competition. It was sponsoring the organizing of the annual entrepreneurship competition. It funded the Eugenics Business Incubator, it participates in European Research Projects Intro Fund, supported the 7th International Conference of Entrepreneurship, which happened actually in November 2016. Here in the University of Cyprus, established the Institute for Research, Innovation and Entrepreneurship at the UCY, and established the Center for Entrepreneurship as well. As part of that effort, UCY is participating in European programs and securing external funding, like programs like Horizon 2020, EU 7th Framework Program, the Life of Learning Program, unified European research area like EUMEDIS and Marie Curie, probably you know more, the Harlambos will tell you more about that. European research projects like GOFLEX and the research, the Cyprus Research Promotion Foundation is trying supposedly to exploit those research results. There were some advances in innovations and patents getting resulting out of that knowledge. Nevertheless, as we'll discuss later, due to the current legislation, which is not very clearly defined or noted, University of Cyprus cannot legally act as the creator of private startup companies. we will discuss it much more later on, but it has to do with the legislation that University of Cyprus was constituted back in its foundation. So the legislative framework of entrepreneurship in UCY. UCY operates within a strict legislative framework as prescribed by the University of Cyprus Law 1989, clause 144/89. Now, this specific law is still active. Okay. Entrepreneurship and innovation are not currently part of the objects of the UCY legislation. So if you read carefully through the lines of this legislation, there are no specific objects for UCY, for the University of Cyprus, that specifically define that entrepreneurship and innovation is part of its objects. If you read the legislation in detail, and Pantelitsa has sent me some links about the legislation, which you can share later on as well. If you go and read, the legislation and the law says that University of Cyprus can be involved in any activity, can sell or buy anything, tangible or intangible assets, as long as those activities serve the purpose of its objects. And within the service of the purpose of within the objects defined in that legislation, you will find research, you will find teaching, you will find collaboration. But there's no specific mention of entrepreneurship. So there's no specific. So that's why it's gray. And, you know, when somebody goes to a court, one can argue the one side and the other one can argue the other side. So it needs to be clarified. UCY is therefore prohibited from participating in a private company which does not pursue fulfillment of its objects. That's the juice of the current legislation. The UCY law is also restricted in relation to the participation of the university in any commercial activity or the participation in any startup which pursues commercial activity. If you remember valorization, and if you Google valorization, you will see a lot of academic institutions abroad using that word, exactly probably for that reason. Because valorization is a more ambiguous, a more generic sense of making value, but at the same time creating commercial activity out of an idea. There are also limitations as to the participation of UCY academic staff in companies without prior approval of the university. There is an existing procedure that if one of the academic staff wants to participate, they have to go and make their case to a certain committee of the university. That procedure exists. Nevertheless, it's restrictive. You have to go through that process. And because of the gray nature of the legislation, it's very hard for anybody to make a quick and reasonable decision. University of Cyprus nevertheless has put in place an IP policy which defines the revenue sharing scheme once you go through the approvals and the acceptance. Now, in order to measure entrepreneurship in UCY, we chose to use a self-assessment tool by OECD. OECD is a global organization which its main purpose is to help the people of the world. So OECD is co-financing a lot of projects along with European Commission in order to make life better for all humans. Back in 2014, UCY used the same self-assessment tool to measure entrepreneurship, and therefore we said that let's try and use that tool for our purpose, for our research as well, and measure the difference
of 2014 to 2016.
And one of our earlier always discussions with our professors and between us was how could we quantify the results, and the questionnaire by OECD exactly did that. The relative comparison we mentioned with AG Innovate report of 2014 was important, and the targeted groups of the questionnaire was the academic faculty, governance and administration. Governance meaning members of the board and administration staff, and of course the research staff in UCY. The questionnaire segments are filtered in seven areas: leadership and governance, organizational capacity, people and incentives, entrepreneurship development, pathways for entrepreneurs, UCY business external relationship for knowledge exchange, UCY as an internationalized institution, and measuring the impact. Measuring the impact meaning measuring what you're doing so far. The participation in the assessment. We sent out 121 questionnaires. The method of delivery of the questionnaire was via SurveyMonkey. So we created, we made a subscription for 2 months, and we created an online questionnaire with SurveyMonkey. SurveyMonkey is a great platform to make these kind of surveys. It provided anonymity, privacy, and also provided some easy reporting tools afterwards for the results. So we sent out 121 requests. The requests were sent via internal email. One of our member team, Yorgos Dimitriou, was part of the academic staff here, not the academic staff, the research staff. And therefore he sent an email link with the SurveyMonkey questionnaire on the internal email system. That provided for the reassurance of people, of responders, that no personal information would be recorded. So there was no trace of the IP or the source of each respondent. Only 39 answered out of the 121 requests sent out. The responses were 51% of those 39 were academic, postdoctoral researchers, 20% governance and administration, and 29% academic faculty. Overall, the average results, we had a 4.3 out of 10 as an average mark. Doesn't say much, but that's just a number. The highest score was marked in UCY as an internationalized institution, 6 out of 10. The lowest score was marked at entrepreneurship development in teaching and learning, 3.7 out of 10. Now let's see each individual questionnaire. Leadership and governance. Please note that this questionnaire was not prepared by us. It was the exact same questionnaire OECD and AG Innovate use. So we didn't change the questions. This is part of an online questionnaire that is probably used by other academic institutions worldwide. So it provides a quite generic and substantial content. First question: entrepreneurship is a major part of the university strategy. This is just asking a question. What is your perception? There is a commitment at high level to implementing the entrepreneurial strategy. Now the responder again responds according to his or her perception. UCY has a model for coordinating and integrating entrepreneurial activities at all levels across the university. Now, this requires probably some knowledge. If the people responding are not aware of a model, then the response would be interesting. The faculties and units have autonomy to act. That's, again, very personal. Each one should know whether they feel autonomous or not. UCY is a driving force for entrepreneurship development in the wider regional, social, and community environment. This is probably perception. How did you do? Question two, the level of commitment has the highest score, and the existence of a model for coordination, question three, has the lowest score, along with the autonomy of faculties. So here we note that probably respondents were not aware, or indeed there is not a model for coordinating within UCY. Academic faculty believe that there is lack of coordination, which probably this supports question two results, in a higher degree than the other groups. So you see, academic faculty, it's the blue, that's the lowest response. However, there is increased level of commitment compared with the 2014 report. The same question, the same questionnaire, there is increased level of commitment compared to the 2014 results. However, no significant change regarding the model of coordination. That probably means that people responding were not aware or there is no model of coordination from 2014 to 2016. The second part, organizational capacity, people and incentives. The university's entrepreneurial objectives are supported by a wide variety of funding sources, investment, including investment by external stakeholders. So this is quite an important part to identify in an academic entrepreneurship environment. The university has a sustainable financial strategy in place to support entrepreneurial development. Our responders, they need to be aware of this or they will answer on perception. There are mechanisms in place for breaking down traditional boundaries and fostering new relationships, bringing internal stakeholders together, staff and students, and building synergies between them. The university is open to recruiting and engaging with individuals who have entrepreneurial attitudes, behaviors, and experience. This is probably very transparent. People should know whether this is happening or not. The university invests in staff development to support its entrepreneurial agenda. There are clear incentives and rewards for staff who actively support the university entrepreneurial agenda. This is very tangible. Of course, it's money, but it's also more than that. But it's concrete. The university gives status and recognition to other stakeholders who contribute to the university's entrepreneurial agenda. This is benchmarking. This is, again, this is something that it's out there. If it's there, it can be measured. What were the results for this? Question 11, statement, has the lowest score. That means low, clear rewards and incentives. That's very clear. The question with the highest score was question 9. What was question 9? The university is open to recruiting and engaging. So there is acknowledgement that university is open to recruiting and engaging with individuals who have entrepreneurial attitudes. So probably the question is what happens afterwards. Academic faculty seems more concerned about the lack of a sustainable financial strategy to promote entrepreneurship. Remember question 7? Was asking about awareness of sustainable financial strategy. Entrepreneurial teaching and learning. That was the third area. UCY is structured in such a way that it stimulates and supports the development of entrepreneurial mindset and skills. Entrepreneurial training for staff takes place in all parts of the university. Staff takes an entrepreneurial approach to teaching in all departments, promoting diversity and innovation in teaching and learning. Entrepreneurial behavior is supported throughout the university experience, from creating awareness and stimulating ideas through the development and implementation. UCY validates entrepreneurship learning outcomes. Collaborating and engaging with external stakeholders is a key component of teaching and learning development in an entrepreneurial university. Now, this is not a question whether UCY is enforcing this. It's a question to the responder whether he or she believes this statement, which is very important to the culture of an academic institution. Research results are integrated into entrepreneurship, education, and training. It's the cycle. Is it coming back? What were the results for this? Our team was a bit high on this special area because as part of the MBA students for 2 years in UCY, we had our own thoughts and discussions about some of these questions. Okay, what did we get? Question 14, training, had the lowest score, 2 out of 8. That's a very loud response for an academic institution who's supposed to be teaching. Quite low. All groups agree that engaging with external stakeholders is a key component. So they all agree on that statement. Comparing with the 2014 report, the situation remains the same or even worse in some cases for that segment.
So this is this Q14 is very interesting.
Yes.
Because you know, you do events and no one comes.
Okay, and we've seen that.
And so there's a perception going on here. So you ask people, they think there's nothing going on. But then you provide training and no one comes.
Okay.
So maybe we don't provide the right training, maybe it doesn't.
You yourself are part of that cycle. And so what do you think?
I mean, in general, maybe people are very busy. Maybe they think that it should be done at the times are not convenient.
There are practical issues, definitely. Practicality always comes with, we are always too busy. And we, as students and working at the same time, we're always too busy to participate in some of those events. For C4E or other events. Nevertheless, we did try, and whenever we were there, we didn't see much people there, especially from the university. I think it has a lot to do with how communication happens in UCY, how these events are communicated, who is the owner of that communication, and who is the owner of the event. Some of the questions later on may shed some more light on the behavioral aspect of that behavior. Definitely there are a lot of things going on. I can say that in the past 2 years I have seen a lot of things going on in UCY. Yes, there are a lot of people outside UCY who don't know what's going on inside, but the people within UCY should know.
Make one comment, and then we had a question from here. Maybe a lot of events are entrepreneurial training, and people don't realize that this is actually entrepreneurial training. Because it says, you know, come to, you know, meet these people that they're going to talk about startups in Israel.
Yes.
Well, what do you think that is? That is entrepreneurial training. Okay? It might have a different title.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying, but that's a very naive approach on, you know, excusing this response. Because you were not dealing with average or, you know, employees, administrative employees. We're dealing with academic, educated people who should not confuse presentations has not been trained. What do you think? Anyway, probably this refers to entrepreneurial focused entrepreneurial development training focused specifically for UCY. I think this probably drills down to that. And the rest of the questions of our experience probably says that there are a lot of things happening in UCY, as you see the ecosystem, there are a lot of entities. So who is connecting the dots? How are the dots connected together? I understand them, there are some recent developments as far as C4E with the roadmap. That's probably a good way, so we'll go through that later. Yes.
When we talk about SAP, we focus on, I think, doctors.
Sorry?
Staff. You mean staff?
Staff?
Professors.
Yeah, we're talking about academic staff.
I don't know about mentality here for Cyprus versus SAP. But in Jordan, I think they do research for promotion, just for them. So I think, and I don't know here.
This is very subjective.
Our challenge for technology transfer is to change, this mentality.
Okay, it has to do with transfer mentality.
So I think
can be included in the group to promote the doctor. It should do something.
Yes, probably that training also, it's part. You know, training always helps to change culture and change behavior. So definitely, it's there. Now, I don't know in UCY, I believe that, no, research is not done only for promotion purposes. No, it's not.
It's culture.
This is a culture. I mean, every country and every different civilization has different angles to view the same issue. The fourth area, which is important in the OECD questionnaire, was pathways for entrepreneurs. Does UCY raise awareness of the value importance of developing entrepreneurial abilities among staff and students? Again, this is perceptions. UCY actively encourages individuals to become entrepreneurial. Responders. UCY provides opportunities to experience entrepreneurship. UCY provides support for individuals and groups to move from entrepreneurial ideas to action. Mentoring by academic and industry personnel is available. UCY facilitates access to private financing for its potential entrepreneurs. UCY provides access to business incubation facilities. Now, remember all these questions are worldwide, the same questions asked to every individual institution. Question 24, regarding availability of mentoring, received the highest score in this segment. It's definitely significantly better than 2014 report, meaning that the recently created mentoring list is gaining awareness. At that time, when we ran the questionnaire, C4E announced a mentor list. So timing was of relevance probably at that time, and people had read the announcement, people were aware of a mentors list, so probably that had a significant impact on that question. Despite the existence of the OENIS incubator, the access to incubation facilities is considered substandard. That's again down to the regulatory and some other concerns regarding the OENIS incubation facilities. Now, the fourth area, business and external relationship for knowledge exchange. UCY is committed to collaboration and knowledge exchange with industry, society, and the public sector. UCY demonstrates active involvement in partnerships and relationships with a wide range of stakeholders. UCY has strong links with incubators, science parks, and other external initiatives, creating opportunities for dynamic knowledge of exchange. UCY provides opportunities for staff and students to take part in entrepreneurial activities with business and external environment. So, you understand that the external ecosystem is very important for the academic entrepreneurship ecosystem. UCY specifically supports staff and student mobility between academia and external environment. This is again very important. Probably Haralambos can tell you more on abroad, on other institutions abroad, why this is so much important. UCY links research, education, and industry, the wider community that is, activities together to affect the whole knowledge ecosystem. Very important to understand, because you cannot promote academic entrepreneurship, you cannot be academically entrepreneurial unless you're part of the ecosystem and unless you are sharing responses. The university is committed to collaboration and knowledge exchange and question 28 mark the highest scores. So there is awareness of commitment and there is awareness of wider partnership and links. However, there is acknowledgement that there is lack of combination of and bringing together the research, education, and industry. Lack of getting the external stakeholders and the internal effort together. The sixth area is regarding the entrepreneurship university as an internationalized institution. This is again important by OECD as identifying whether that entrepreneurial university is part of the bigger international scene. Internationalization is a key part of the university's entrepreneurial strategy. The university explicitly supports the international mobility of staff and students. The university seeks and attracts international entrepreneurial staff, including teaching, research, and PhDs. The university demonstrates internationalization in its approach to teaching. The university, its departments and faculties actively participate in international networks. UCY, according to these responses, shows an extrovert behavior and is part of the international scene through networks, mobility, and research projects. There is some difficulty to attract international staff, and this, we say, is probably due to the language barrier. In 2014 report, this segment also had the highest performance in the questionnaire. This shows a consistent effort towards internationalization with regards to UCY. This probably has to do that most of the academic staff are already established, well-connected academic community members internationally. So when they're coming back to the UCY, or coming to UCY, they bring along their contacts, they bring along their clout. The last and important part is measuring the impact. Benchmarking. UCY assesses the impact of its entrepreneurial strategy, and the strategy is responsive to change. Does this happen? Respondents need to answer. Are they aware of this? UCY assesses the level of engagement in entrepreneurial teaching. UCY regularly assesses the impact of entrepreneurship teaching and learning. UCY carries out regular monitoring and evaluation of the university knowledge exchange activities. Does UCY carry out regular monitoring and evaluation of the impact of startup support?
Excuse me. Do you know any of the instruments that is used for measuring this outcome? For measuring the results of the entrepreneurship strategy and activities, and how they measure the output of the activities they do, and
the purpose of this question is exactly that question. It's first is asking whether this is happening, and the results will show whether it's happening or not. And if it's not happening, then you're not asking for two. So this questionnaire is just asking, are you aware of this happening? Is this happening, yes or no? How much is happening?
No, you don't know how they measure the, what instruments they use to measure the output of the,
this is not happening yet. I believe this is not happening yet in that formal expected manner. This is how I understand.
It's about the convenience.
So the university doesn't have anything to measure the output.
Let's see what they answer. There is a lot of room for improvement in this section, as the overall average is 3.8, which is one of the lowest marks. So our understanding is that there are no, at least known, formal methods of assessment, of measuring the impact of entrepreneurship within. Here we have to note something though. Because UCY is part of that international cloud, and because it's participating recently and ever more increasingly lately in other international projects, European funded, those projects themselves, they've got measurement mechanisms within the projects themselves. Those projects themselves are focused on the target and the specific purpose of that project. And those projects, once they are funded by international institutions or European Union, you will find very detailed and very formal methods of assessment of that process.
There's no example
but
for methods.
As far as the whole entrepreneurship mentality, and this is where we're driving at. I mean, this is what this questionnaire digs out and brings forward. There is none. There is none known in that formal manner. But since UCY started using this questionnaire in 2014, it means that they were on the path of developing that measurement, because this questionnaire itself is an essential part of that assessment.
Yeah, okay. Other than survey and examples, or do you know about some projects, what they use to measure the outputs of their projects or activities?
Well, yeah, if you go to the technology licensing office of MIT, you type in technology licensing office MIT, you go there, you read reports from them. They measure number of patents, they measure number of companies, they measure funding that those companies got, licensing revenue. So they actually track it, but they have a lot more history and experience in this. The University of Cyprus, I think, part of not tracking it is because they thought it's so new. But just like with everything, if you want it to improve, you have to track it. So even though it's very early on, you should put some metrics.
It's like an industry. You cannot manage something you cannot measure. You cannot make something better if you cannot measure. This is life. Can you make your food better unless you taste it? Can you reduce your electricity bill unless you measure it? It's the same thing. So we need to measure. This survey formalized that assessment. So we had a lot of findings in our report. So for this presentation and the presentation we did, we focused on this. Fostering entrepreneurship is part of UCY's major strategy, and there is high-level management commitment from what we have seen and what we have witnessed. In addition, an increase in this level of commitment is noticeable compared to 2014. However, collaborative culture across departments of UCY towards entrepreneurship seems to be lacking. There are no clear incentives to promote entrepreneurial behavior amongst academic and research staff. Entrepreneurial teaching and learning and staff development is considered to be substandard. Although UCY has strong ties with external stakeholders, they are not strong enough with external incubators, accelerators, or science parks that will focus on entrepreneurial activity and startups and fostering that entrepreneurial activity. The recently created mentoring used by C4E was gaining awareness and is considered a significant measure to create a pathway for entrepreneurship culture. Internationalization is a significant aspect of UCY, and its departments and faculties actively participate in international networks. So this is a fact. Measuring the impact of changes is low, and there is no regular monitoring or evaluation of the actions taken to support entrepreneurship. So that's recognized. And definitely, the current legislative background of the university is restrictive and limiting promoting entrepreneurial initiatives. That was, up to recently, one of the major obstacles claimed by all stakeholders. There is an update to this, as Pandelica informed me lately. There has been a proposed framework agreed between, mutually agreed between the public universities of Cyprus. And this proposed framework has been brought forward to the external involved parties of the Cyprus, of the Republic of Cyprus, and that means the parliament, the legislators, the Ministry of Finance, and the government itself. And the rest institutions that are part of this ecosystem in order to move forward and make changes to the legislation. Once those, those changes are made to the legislation, we believe that there will be no obstacles at all in pursuing further. So the recommendations. The university should create a clear roadmap to coordinate and integrate all entrepreneurial activities across existing structures. There are a lot of structures. There is a lot of brain power and facilities and all the right constituent parts exist in UCY. But they need to be put in place together. They need to be coordinated. This could be also create economies of scale, increase the efficiency of operations, but leverage the power of UCY towards entrepreneurship. We believed at that time, we probably believe that now, that UCY is the most prominent academic institution in Cyprus. Its academic brain power is it's compared to none in the island. So there is nothing, there is no skills limitation here. The UCY Council, there's an update by Vanderitsa that the UCY Council approved the C4E roadmap, which is, it was a suggested roadmap for extracting, promoting collaboration and coordination of efforts within UCY. Emphasis should be given to incentivizing staff as well as providing them with the necessary time and support for training and development. So incentives and time. What Haran was said before, it's something that we debated with Professor Cassinis at that time, that and some academic institutions also are researching this and writing on this. You cannot learn, you cannot make change, create change, unless you provide time for employees, time for staff, for all stakeholders in place to do that. If everybody's too busy, then they do have a good excuse for not doing it. internationalization is a major part of UCY, but this is not viewed under an entrepreneurship lens. The international networks and the engagement with external stakeholders should be further exploited toward that end. All the UCY staff are, and the questionnaire did show that, it has a very strong score on internationalization. UCY can make more use of that towards the entrepreneurial spirit. The university should focus towards creating stronger links with accelerators and incubators, both in the local and international rights. First, they can start with the local. There is a significant amount of accelerators, incubators, slash entities around the Cyprus ecosystem today. And because of their flexibility to work and do things differently than in a formalized institution, they can provide the methods and the environment to cultivate entrepreneurship. One thing we identified, we discussed between us, and we have witnessed through the MBA program as well, is that there needs to be more of embedding entrepreneurship courses and initiatives into undergraduate and postgraduate curriculum in order to promote culture. Last year we had visited Hanse University of Groningen, which has made wonders as far as entrepreneurship in the energy sector in the past 10 years. So if you look at the University of Groningen and the Hanse School, you will see that they have created and they have managed to absorb a lot of funding from European funds and the private equity, like the energy firms, the big energy firms, because they managed to embed entrepreneurship courses into undergraduate courses and into postgraduate courses. In fact, in the University of Groningen, there is an option where you can take a minor, like the American system, you can take a minor in entrepreneurship while you're doing business economics or something. So there is a whole angle to that element. And this would also promote culture. It would promote culture through the young minds of the community, but also promote culture within the academic staff as well. There should be more usage of English language in order to attract non-Greek speaking faculty and students. Measuring the impact and taking into account any feedback consistently to achieve sustainable entrepreneurship. If you don't measure it, you cannot make it better. The legislative framework should be amended, and I believe we're probably on the right track on that. I'm not aware of the details of that legislation, but efforts are being made to make the necessary changes to that legislation so that it allows the UCY to go further. Thank you on behalf of our team. And